Welcome students, today we are going to study civics chapter 2nd, role of the government in health. In democracy, people expect the government to work for their welfare and betterment. In that, government works various ways, like in the field of education, in the field of maintaining law and order in the society, maintaining and building roads and transportation, and so on. Like that, in the field of health also, government plays very important role, and that we are going to study from this chapter. Now, what we will learn from this chapter? We are going to learn from this chapter what is health, healthcare system compare and contrast, public healthcare system, private healthcare system, why we pay taxes to the government, and case studies of one of the Indian state, Kerala, and Costa Rican government. Step by step, all these points we are going to cover from this chapter. Now, what is health? Health means ability to remain free of illness and injuries. Many a times we use this word health. My health is not good. Healthy environment, healthy food. So related to health, related to words, similar sound words we used various purpose. So health means our ability to remain free of illness and injuries. In broader sense, health means something more than this. Health means just not associated with our body. Apart from disease, we need to think of the other factors such as clean drinking water, pollution-free surroundings, etc., that affect our health. It means that health is not associated just only our body, but also related to our surrounding also. If we are not getting clean drinking water or pollution-free surroundings, we are not healthy. Adequate food, proper food, healthy diet is also essential for keeping ourselves in good health. So our good health is depend on adequate food also, proper food, proper diet which require our body. So these all points are considered in health. Now, healthcare in India, let us examine some of the aspects of healthcare in India. These two columns tells us about the progress in the field of healthcare system and the failure also. So in the first column, India has the largest number of medical colleges in the world. My dear students, in India, every year approximately 15,000 doctors qualifying every year. But then too, these doctors, they are preferring to settle in urban areas, city areas. And cause of that, most of the rural areas, people have to travel long distances to reach doctor. Sometimes without getting any medical help, they faced severe problems. The number of doctors with respect to the population is much less in rural areas. Here see, healthcare facilities have grown substantially over the years. After independence, in 1950, there were only 2,717 hospitals in India, and then it is in the year 2000, the number grew 18,218. But the failure is that about 5 lakh people die from tuberculosis every year. Tuberculosis, one of communicable disease which spread due to air. It is also called as airborne disease. This number is almost unchanged since independence. Means after independence, even though we have seen their growth in hospitals, growth in the number of doctors, but then too, these diseases were unchanged. People, those who are falling ill, unchanged. India gets a large number of medical tourists. Now here, very important concept, new concept for you. Medical tourist means the person, foreigner, who come to our country to get treatment. Because of, in our country, many hospitals are the best in the world. Because of that, thousands of medical tourists, they visit to our country for treatment purpose. Here failure we can see, we are not able to provide clean drinking water to all. And 21% of communicable diseases are waterborne diseases. It means that our failure to provide clean drinking water to the people, common people, and cause of that people, they fall due to fall ill due to diarrhea, hepatitis and all. My dear students, one of the great success in the field of health, our governments, that is India is the fourth largest producer of medicines in the world and also a large exporter of medicines. Means from here to our country, most probably huge number of medicines boxes exporting to the other countries. Here in our country, most probably half of children in India do not get adequate food to eat and are undernourished, malnourished, and cause of that their health issues are severe in front of the Indian government. So here we have studied from this table healthcare in India success, as well as in this second column we studied about the failures also. Now importance of health. What is importance of health? A life with stress will lead us to illness, mental illness. Hence we need to be without mental strain, without mental stress. We should live our life stress-free life. Thus good health include both a sound mind and a sound body. Good health includes both healthy mind, healthy body. We need proper healthcare facilities to maintain good health. In India, although all resources are available, as we have seen in the previous table, medical facilities with the hospitals, doctors, medicines, but still we are not able to get proper medical facilities and treatment. Here one of the story of Hakim Sheikh story, we will see how we are not getting proper medical facilities and treatment. Let's see. Here the story of Hakim Sheikh. Here see my dear students, Hakim Sheikh, he was a member of Paschim Banga Khet Mazdoor Samiti. Here see, what is Paschim Banga Mazdoor Samiti? Paschim Banga Khet Mazdoor Samiti, an organization of agricultural laborers in West Bengal. So what is Paschim Banga Khet Mazdoor Samiti? It is an organization of agricultural laborers in West Bengal. So Hakim Sheikh, he was also one of agricultural labor in West Bengal. One evening in 1992, he accidentally fell off a running train and suffered head injuries. He was in a very serious condition and needed immediate treatment. Now see, when he got an accident, he fell off a running train and due to that he suffered head injury. What happened then? He was taken to a government hospital in Kolkata, as West Bengal, Kolkata, but they refused to admit him. Even though government hospital, they refused, they denied, they not agreed to admit him. Because why? They did not have a spare bed, empty bed, extra bed over there. Another hospital did not have the facility or the specialized doctor necessary for his treatment. You know, see Kolkata, big city, and in big city many government hospitals are there. So this Hakim Sheikh was taken one hospital to another, but there were due to the some of the reasons like not spare bed, like not having facilities, not having specialized doctors, necessary treatment, nobody agreed to admit him. In this way he spent 14 hours in critical state and was taken to 8 different government hospitals. but none of them admitted him. In that state, in that critical state, Hakim Sheikh, one to another, another to further went near about 8 different government hospitals, but none of them admitted him. Finally, he was admitted in a private hospital. Private means owned by individual for the profit purpose. So he was taken, he was admitted to private hospital where he received treatment. Okay, but he spent a lot of money on his treatment. And we know that Hakim Sheikh, he was just only agricultural labor. So lot of money not affordable by Hakim Sheikh. Angry and upset over the indifferent attitude of all hospitals that refused to admit him, Hakim Sheikh and PBKMS filed a case in the court. PBKMS, Paschim Banga Khet Mazdoor Samiti. They got angry because near about 8 government hospitals refused. It shows that even though lot of good healthcare facilities are there, lot of medical availability, medical aid availability is there, doctor availability is there, then to poor people they faced problems. Now, the next one of the story, the cost of a cure. This is the story of Aman and Ranjan. One of the friend was wealthy and one of the friend was poor. And this is the story about when they fall ill, they treated in the different hospitals. One of the wealthy friends, he went to private hospitals, spend lot of money and get medical aid as much as early, and he got well also, very much early. Another poor friend, his family took him to government hospital where he faced lot many problems, like standing in a long queue, then for getting medical treatment from the doctors, he required to wait long duration and all. So this was also the picture we can see from our country, and also it shows the difference between the private and government hospitals. Now, the very important point, why we pay taxes to the government. Here in medical, in the health area, here this is quite new point you may think, but it is very much related why we pay taxes to the government. Government uses tax money for providing many public services for the benefits of all citizens. Some services such as defense, police, judicial system, highways, etc. benefit of all citizens. Otherwise, the citizens cannot organize these services for themselves. We are paying various taxes to the government, like electricity tax, as well as house tax, water tax, and so on. Taxes fund developmental programs and services such as education, healthcare, employment, social welfare, vocational training, etc. required for needy citizens. Tax money is utilized for relief and rehabilitation in case of natural disaster such as flood, earthquake, tsunami, etc. Space, nuclear and missile programs are also funded from the revenue collected as taxes. We are paying taxes to the government. So tax is very important source to the government for developing various areas such as laws as well as maintaining peace in the society, building transportation. We have seen space, nuclear, missiles during the natural disaster, mitigation purpose also, lot of money required, as well as very important aspect, that is health. So various healthcare system which developed by the government, and government fulfilling those costs with the help of taxes. So that's why we should have to pay taxes to the government time to time. Now, healthcare facilities. Healthcare facilities include health centers, hospitals, laboratories for tests, ambulance services, blood banks. See, healthcare facilities means for maintaining proper healthcare system in society. Various facilities are required, not just only doctors or medicines, but also health centers, hospitals, laboratories where technicians, lab technicians, they perform blood test, urine test and so on, ambulance services, blood banks, etc. In order to run such facilities, we need health workers, nurses, qualified doctors. We also need medicines and equipments that are essential for treating patients. So healthcare facilities in it all human laborers as well as the machineries as well as the various especially medicines, various equipments we require in the healthcare facilities. India has no dearth of qualified doctors, as we have seen every year near about 15,000 doctors becoming qualified. There are large number of clinics and hospitals too. Perhaps therefore a large number of medical tourists come to our country for treatment at a reasonable cost. Thousands of medical tourists also we have seen come to our country because to get good medical facilities. India is the fourth largest producer of medicine in the world and also large exporter of medicines. Despite all this, but the health situation in our country is very poor. The health situation is not good. The reason is that the government fails to make necessary healthcare available to all. Healthcare facilities are there, doctors are there, nurses are there, medicines are there, labs are there, as well as availability of ambulance. Everything is there. But the government fails making these healthcare facilities available to all, to commoners. The public health service is a chain of health centers and hospitals run by government. It is found in both the rural and urban areas. There is a chain under which government make available this healthcare system to all. That is called as public health service. Here see, public means run by the government for the welfare of people, for all. So public health service, it is a chain of health centers which is running by the government and also which is found in not only in rural areas but also in urban areas also. At the village level, there are health centers where there is usually a nurse and village health worker. They deal with common illness such as fever, cold, cough, etc. When serious condition, they refer to the district hospitals. At the district level is the district hospital that supervises all the health centers. Now you can see, suppose this is village, these are the villages, and on these villages what is there? Health centers where nurse and village health worker, they deal with common diseases. And this is suppose district hospital. These district hospitals are connected with these health centers, and these district hospitals, they run various campaigns such as polio campaign, as well as when any disease outbreak, so making awareness about that disease to all these villagers which are linked to this district hospital. So district hospital, what responsibility? Supervise all these villagers and villagers' health. So these health center, they are connected with this district hospital. Now main features of public health system. Which are the main features of public health system? Big cities have many government hospitals, more than one. Like we have seen in Hakim Sheikh's story, to the Hakim Sheikh in Kolkata city, the people, they took to Hakim Sheikh 8 various government hospitals. So in big cities have many government hospitals because big cities, much population, much wider areas, cause of that one hospital is not sufficient, and hence many government hospitals are there. Under the public health system, quality healthcare services are provided either free or at low cost so that even the poor can seek treatment. Very important, free of cost or lower cost. Good quality healthcare services are provided by the government. Under this system, the action is also taken to prevent the spread of disease like tuberculosis, malaria, jaundice, cholera, diarrhea, chikungunya, or other communicable diseases. So, this public healthcare system, they run various actions whenever any disease outbreak. Wide range of private health facilities exist in our country. A large number of doctors run their own private clinics, but these private clinics are most probably situated in urban areas, city areas. In the rural areas, registered medical practitioner means RMPs, registered medical practitioners are found, whereas in the urban areas, a large number of doctors can be seen. In rural areas, registered medical practitioners, they provide their service, and in urban areas, most probably doctors can be seen. There are hospitals and nursing homes that are privately owned and not run by the government. These nursing homes totally, they are running for the profit purpose. Unlike public health services, in private hospitals, patients have to pay a lot of money for their treatment. See, in private hospitals, patients, they require lot of money for various purpose, for checking, for blood, as well as to get the other facilities like surgery and all. They have to pay lot of money for their treatment, and it is very, very problematic for the poor people to get availability of such a private hospitals. In our country, private services are increasing, but public services are not. See, private services are increasing. These private services are providing health services, but public services are not. In the Hakim Sheikh story, we have seen, even though 8 government hospitals, they not taken Hakim Sheikh, means they not admitted Hakim Sheikh, but the such Hakim Sheikh, he was admitted to private hospital, and private hospital took lot of money from Hakim Sheikh. So as the private hospitals run for profit, the cost of these services is rather high, very high, because these private hospitals owned by individuals, not by government. So that's why their intention, total intention, run for the profit, earn profit, lot of profit, and that's why their costs are especially these private hospitals costs are rather high. Poor people find it difficult to get treatment here. Adequate healthcare is not available to all in country. Only 20% of the population can afford all the medicines that they require during illness. But then too, we can see, even in our family also, when someone fall ill, we used to go to private hospitals only, because of private hospitals are situated everywhere, and for that reason we used to think the many factors, such as it is quite close, as well as clean surroundings, and availability of good, we can used to say the near to our home as well as the process is very easy process to get admitted in the hospital, and for that reason we used to prefer to go to private hospital. It has been found that 40% of people who are admitted to hospital for some illness have to borrow money or sell some of their possessions to pay for the expenses. Only 20%, as here we have seen, 20% of the population can afford. But we can see not just 20% of population go to private hospital. Near about 50%, more than 50% of population used to prefer private hospitals. But how they arrange money? They borrow money or sell something, their possessions like gold, like vehicles. Sometimes they sell in village areas. We used to see they sell their cows or their cattle, and they admitted in the hospital to pay the bill of hospital. Is adequate healthcare available to all? Now, as we have seen in the previous slide, adequate healthcare facility, to get healthcare facility in government, it is quite difficult, or the process is quite long. Cause of that, people, they used to prefer to go to private hospitals. For that reason, they sell their belongings or sell their cattle also. For the poor, every illness is curse. Every illness is curse. It is not easy situation in front of there when any family member get ill. As they are undernourished and live in unhygienic conditions, undernourished, not getting adequate food, not getting unhygienic condition, hygienic conditions, and cause of that, due to undernourished and due to unhygienic condition, they frequently fall ill. We have seen in the first slide that clean drinking water or pollution-free environment makes us healthy. But these poor, they are not getting clean drinking water facilities, clean drinking water, as well as they live in unhygienic conditions like slums, in city areas. Most probably houses are very small, gutters are running near from the houses, as well as the dump of heap of garbage is lying over there. So that's why these, especially poor people, they frequently fall ill. The expenses on illness make their situation even worse, and if they fall ill again, what they require? They require money, and hence their condition, situation becoming worst. So far, women's health is associated, it is easily ignored. Most probably, women's health is ignored in poor families. Many tribal areas have few health centers. Tribal families, they live far from one another. They live on mountainous or hilly terrains, and cause of that, they were not getting proper medical health care. Thus, we can say without a doubt that the health situation of most people in our country is not good. In which cases? In the poor, in women's case, as well as in tribal, also we have seen in villages, very less healthcare facilities are there. However, Kerala, one of Indian South Indian state, has made efforts to provide adequate healthcare to people of the state. Kerala, one of the state which put one of the very unique administrative step in front of the other state, that made efforts to provide adequate healthcare to people of the state. Costa Rica, also one of the country in North America, it is considered to be one of the healthiest country in the continent. The Costa Rican government curtailed means they quite reduced the expenses on the army to spend it on health, education, and other basic needs of the people. What government they did? They curtailed, they reduced the expenses on the army, and that expenses means that cost they spent on the health and education, because health and education, these two terms are closely related, because if we are educated, then we can come to know which are the severe or hazardous situation when we are not healthy or when we are not in good surrounding and all. So education gives us feel about how to live healthy. It provides them with safe drinking water, sanitation, nutrition and housing. So these are the case studies we can see broadly here in these slides. The Kerala experience. In 1996, the Kerala government made some major changes in the state. 40% of entire state, how much? 40% of their tax collection. This 40% of the tax collection means entire state budget was given to panchayat. Panchayat means to whom? To rural or villages. They could plan and provide for their requirements. This made it possible for a village to make sure that proper planning was done for water. Now see, the government provided 40% of their budget to the villages, and these villagers, what they have done, they planned for clean drinking water, food, as well as women's development and education. On these very important four basic things, water, food, women's development and education, very important aspects in very important areas. Here, this means that water supply schemes were checked, the working of schools and Anganwadis was ensured, and specific problems of the village were taken up. In the field of women, availability of water, clean water, as well as food for the Anganwadis, and development on the education. For that, Kerala government reserved 40% of their budget. All of this helped to improve the situation. And despite these efforts, however, some problems such as shortages of medicines, insufficient hospital beds, not enough doctors remained, and these needed to be addressed. So here, even though government's effort in the other aspects, but there then too we can see there was a gap in the healthcare services not reached up to the villagers in the proper quantity. Now the Costa Rican approach. Costa Rica is considered to be one of the healthiest countries in North America. The main reason for this can be found in Costa Rican constitution. Several years ago, Costa Rica took a very important decision. And this country, which decision they have taken? They decided not to have an army. Whatever budget or whatever money we are spending on army, it is, we should have to stop. And that only, this helped the Costa Rican government to spend the money that the army would have used on health, education and other basic needs for the people. So what the government decided? To spend on health, education and other basic needs such as food, such as on the women's education. The Costa Rican government believes that a country has to be healthy for its development and pays a lot of attention to the health of its people. So health, it is very important aspect in front of the government, that if the people they are healthy, then only the country's development will be there. So here, sanitation, good drinking water, nutrition and housing, health education is also very, very important things, and for that reason Costa Rican governments made planned and succeeded also. So this was the country become the role model, one of the role model in front of all the countries becoming healthiest countries. And we can use to say these basic points but makes big difference. I hope you understood this chapter. Thank you.